Hi everyone. Wishing you all a very happy Diwali. And like Team India, I think the markets also had a good week last week. I'm sure most of you are still recovering from that very exciting and scintillating match yesterday, and as am I. But with that, let's get into the performance of markets and factors last week. So as you can see, you know, the market did bounce back last week, and on a weekly basis, the broader market factor did about 2.3%, followed by value and momentum, both up about 2%. Quality was up the least, but still up about 1.2%. So it's been a decent week altogether for the market. Monthly also value bounced back, as has the market, followed by small cap and momentum, and the other three factors have also finished in the green. So year to date, however, it's just quality and market which are still in green. Momentum is flat, a little bit on the negative side, the low wall. But what surprising, and again not so surprising also, to see that value, which had begun the year very strongly, has given up most of its gains and is now negative 2%. Small caps have been hit the most, and they continue to be the laggards at minus 13%. The combination of momentum and low volatility is doing the best year to date as of now. With that, just let's look at the factor trend. So value, like we saw last week, was down. This week is again up. So it's sort of bobbing around that trend level, trying to make up its mind whether to go up or down. I think it will mostly follow the market direction, but maybe not gain as much as it has in the last year or so. The momentum has been up, quality is up, and the low wall is up. Small cap continues to remain in a downtrend. So the seven factors, the six are up and one is down. With that, let's get into the sector performance. And we've seen that the last couple of months, banks and financials have been pretty strong. Energy is recovered, but not metal. Metal is in the negative this week. FMCG also had a good week, as has auto. Auto has been a good, strong performer. And good to see that, you know, IT even had a positive close this week. So the month has been good for IT, banks, and finance. Auto has been just about flat. FMCG also around flat. However, when we get to the year-to-date picture, we see that it's FMCG, which is a defensive trend, which is up the most, followed by auto, followed by bank, and energy. So these four sectors are firmly in the green. What's been hit the most is IT, and it continues to be the biggest loser for the year, down about 26-27%, followed by Realty and pharma. So pharma, IT continue to be the, you know, the persistent laggard. Energy has given up some of its gains, but still holding on to about 15%. Metal has given up most of its gains also, and is now just above up about 4% for the year to date. Banks have rotated back into the green, up about 15%. Auto up about 16%, and FMCG, like I said, doing the best at about 18%. That lets you see the trends. Trends have not changed except for infra, right? Infra, which was down last week, is now up this week. Other than that, IT is down, media is down, and energy is down. So seven sectors up, four sectors down. The rally is pretty broad-based. If you want all of this in your inbox, you can still go to factorinvestor.substack.com and subscribe there. And we are coming out with a new format this month. So probably you'll get it in early November, the October edition. Once October ends, we'll come out with that new edition and new format for the factor investor report. This is our factor all weather. like we said at the beginning of the month, value went into a downtrend. So that was replaced by gold. About 67-70% in risk on mode and about 30-33% in risk off mode. With that, we come to the end of this week's update. This week, the coming week, starting today, is a truncated week. Today, we have morning trading. Tomorrow is normal working. But again, Wednesday, we have a holiday. So it's going to be a truncated week this week. But enjoy your holidays. The markets seem to be doing okay. So don't be worried about that. With that, we come to the end of this video. So disclaimer that it's not investment advice, it's purely for educational purposes only, and please consult an investment advisor before investing. You can follow me on Twitter at Anish Paley, at QADCap, and visit us at QADCap.com. Send us questions on our YouTube channel, and do like, subscribe, and follow us, and spread the word. So see you again next week, and until then, have a happy week, have a happy Diwali, and a prosperous New Year.